The three most common types of seawalls are concrete, composite, and vinyl. Concrete is by far the strongest option, but unfortunately, due to the size of equipment necessary to set the concrete panels, it becomes restrictive because it's difficult to get the large equipment into the back of the property. From there, you go to either a composite or a vinyl material, which doesn't require the large equipment, and therefore it has become the most prevalent of the seawall materials. When a vinyl or a composite seawall is used, it's typically installed in front of the existing seawall, and the void between the old wall and the new wall is filled with steel reinforced concrete, virtually making it a pour in place concrete wall. In this picture, you can see the seawall panels, the void between the existing wall and the new wall that is filled with steel reinforced concrete, and the amount of steel that is running the length of the cap just before pouring in the concrete. Then there is a new cap and tieback system installed encasing the old wall and the new wall. The new concrete seawalls are 8 inches thick with steel reinforcement and many additives to the concrete, making it much stronger than the original seawalls that were installed. When considering a vinyl wall, although they all look the same on the outside, there's many different building materials that can be used, and things that need to be considered are the strength of the panel, the length of the panel, what you are using to fill the void between the existing wall and the new wall, as well as the amount of steel that is going into the seawall cap, the strength of the concrete that is used, and the type of tieback system that's being used. Duncan Seawall is one of the few contractors, if the only contractor in the area, that has the expertise and equipment to be able to set a concrete seawall panel.